Hello everyone, welcome back to the second tutorial. In the first video, we introduced how to use mean squared error to fit a linear regression model. In this video, we will continue fitting a linear model, but using another method called maximum likelihood estimation. Before diving into maximum likelihood estimation, I'd like to introduce Gaussian distribution or normal distribution. Data can be distributed in different ways, but there are many cases where the data tends to be around a central value with no bias left or right. It gets close to a Gaussian distribution like this. The green bars formulate a histogram of data X. It tells the probability of the occurrence of each possible value of X. We can draw a bell-shaped curve around it, and this bell curve is what we call Gaussian distribution function. A Gaussian distribution function is defined by a mean parameter mu and a standard deviation sigma, which is larger than zero. The mean is where the peak is at, and the sigma is a measure of how spread out the data distribution is. The variance of the distribution is sigma squared. And a general form of the probability density function is f of x, written as this form. Okay, and this is the orange curve in this figure. So why we introduce Gaussian distribution here? Usually it's used to model the noise in the observed data. Here is what I mean by saying noise. If we generate y from x using this linear model, where x is a deterministic input, theta is also a deterministic value, then y would be a definite value without uncertainty. All the data would be on this straight line. Okay. However, this is the data we usually observe in real-world scenarios. There is deviation from data to the line, which is usually referred to as noise. Noise could mean something we don't care about, for example, the deviation from mean fair rate, or it can be what we can control, such as the measurement noise. So when we do model fitting, we want to take noise into consideration. Thus, we add an additional term eta to the linear model. This eta is not a deterministic value. We usually assume it's a random variable from a Gaussian distribution. When eta is from Gaussian with zero mean and sigma squared variance, y would be a random variable from a Gaussian too. And the mean of this Gaussian is at the theta multiplying x. Formally, we consider the linear regression model with a Gaussian distributed noise eta with zero mean and variance is equal to sigma squared. We can write the encoding model Py given x and theta as this Gaussian form. The larger the sigma squared value is, the noisier the data is. Therefore, if we have a very noisy data set, we would assume a large sigma value and vice versa. Here we can visualize the distribution of Py given x and theta if we know the true value of theta. For an arbitrary x, say x is equal to 8, we can slice this 2D distribution and plot the 1D version. The orange bell-shaped curve describes the Gaussian density function. The mean is at 8 multiplying theta now, and the standard deviation is sigma. This is just an example of the 1D slice visualization of Py given x and theta. We could also take another slice, say at x is equal to 2, and visualize the 1D distribution function. This is now a 1D Gaussian with the mean at 2 multiplying theta. Okay, now we have already shown how the distribution of Py given x and theta looks. Then the problem we try to solve is, given these observed x and y, we have the assumption that the encoding model from x to y would be this Gaussian form. Then what is the theta that leads to the best fit of the model to the data? If theta is 0.5, Py given x and theta looks like this. And if theta is 1.2, the distribution rotates which seems to match the data better. And we keep increasing theta to be 2.2, the distribution further rotates up and misses the data again. So to find the best theta, we can now introduce the term likelihood. It's a function of parameter theta and used to determine which theta leads to the Gaussian distribution that most likely matches the data points x and y. And it's usually defined to be the probability density distribution p. And for the three theta values, we could calculate the likelihoods and arrive at the results that the likelihood of theta 1.2 is larger than the likelihood of theta 0.5 and the likelihood of theta is equal to 2.2. Okay, therefore, we could calculate the optimal theta by maximizing the likelihood. Empirically, we maximize the log likelihood instead of the likelihood function itself. Here we derive the log likelihood expression for you. We first write down the log likelihood as the log of the productive density function for all n data points. And we then move the product to the outside of the logarithm, which becomes a summation. Then we separate the log into two terms. The first term is constant across data points, therefore we can write it as n over 2 multiplying log of 2 pi sigma squared. And in the second term, logarithm is cancelled by exponential, thus the final form is just a sum over quadratics. We notice that this second term is actually the negative of n multiplying msc. Therefore, by just staring at the log likelihood function, we can foresee that maximizing the log likelihood should give us the same solution as minimizing MSC. Again, we could differentiate this function and set the gradient to be zero. We arrive at the closed form solution for MLE, which is exactly the same as MSC solution. But notice that this equality is only true when Py given x and theta is Gaussian. Again, we plot theta MLE on the landscape figure together with theta MSE and the true theta. Not surprisingly, theta MLE overlaps with theta MSE, which means it's also a good estimator. So in the following notebook, you will code for likelihood function for Gaussian distribution. You will fit linear regression with MLE estimator. Hope you enjoy.